Cascade style sheet, they use three types. The first one is the inline part, second one is the internal CSS, and in the next case we are going to use an external CSS, and that is why we will be needing to create a separate stylesheet.css. In that particular case, I would like to recommend here that always in the first place create a new folder which should be known as CSS, and inside this new folder we are now creating a file which should be termed as stylesheet.css. And here it goes, this is the stylesheet.css. So why did we place this stylesheet.css into a separate folder? Always keep in mind that while you will be creating some actual project, you will be working live on a particular project, there should be a numerous number of CSS files or a number of fonts, those will be practically used here, and in that case you will be needing a separate folder where all like type content like this .css files, leaf icon files or those font awesome files, all those things should be placed inside a particular CSS from where fetching will be easily done. And that is why we have created a separate folder inside the root folder of HTML CSS integration. And inside this particular CSS folder, inside this CSS folder, we will be placing this stylesheet.css. Now in the very first case, all we need to do, we need to define the char set which is practically being used over here. And on the other hand, we need to mention that this is practically a CSS document. So these are the things that in the first case we need to define. This is practically defining that it is obeying the character set of UTF-8. This is a kind of declaration that is needed to be declared on top of every CSS document. And on the next case, we need to declare this one, the CSS document type. This is practically a CSS comment. We will be knowing about it, how to make a CSS comment. I'm sorry, we have forgotten to provide a semicolon over here. So practically every particular CSS document, it is practically composed of, first of all, the class or an ID. So in case of class, you need to provide this dot or full stop, and in case of an ID, you need to provide a hashtag. So in case if you are using a full stop or a dot, then you are declaring a class to be attributed, and in case if you are using a hashtag, then it is an ID. Remember that an ID is the fastest selector into a CSS document. Any selector name can be obtained very easily if it is attributed with an ID. On the other hand, a class, it can be used many times, while an ID can be used for once only into the same page. That means if you create an ID like this one, and if you name it as a selector, this particular ID, it can be used once into this particular index.html. And if you use here a selector name, selector class actually, then it can be used multiple times into this particular index.html or into your project. So that is why ID is the fastest selector, as it can be used once. What is an universal selector? It is practically used to provide some particular attributes for all of the elements which is present into a particular page. For say into this index.html, it will be having the same property for all of these elements inside your index.html. So if we use here, if we declare here, this should be an universal element, and if we now provide here margin 0 and a padding 0, in that particular case every element inside this particular index.html, they will be having a constant 0 margin and 0 padding. So this is the purpose of universal selector. This asterisk sign, it is practically serving as the universal selector. This is an actual syntax in case of CSS universal selector. On the other hand, as we have termed previously, that there are some general selectors such as we know that in this particular case we have used this h2, this header tag, or this div element over here. So all those things are practically general tags. That means the tags, those are already in use in your HTML page. All you need to do, you need to mention it as this one. No need to define any class or ID, because these things are not user defined. This thing is already been present into your HTML document, and they are known as the general tags. So we are now just defining the property of those general tags. Those have been used into index.html, and in that case we have targeted this particular HTML element over there. So in this case we are now providing a background color of, for say, 000. Let's provide a dark black color and see what happens next. So this is the general selector that is being used over here, and this is the universal selector. Now in this particular case we need to link this stylesheet.css with this index.html. So we are getting back to our project, into our index.html, and first of all we are removing this style. We are not using any internal CSS over here, so we don't need to declare any kind of style element. So that is why we are removing it. And instead, as we have told you previously, that head is the segment where you can define all of your sources. So the exact same thing should be carried on over here. We are now defining we need to link this stylesheet.css with this index.html, and where exactly this stylesheet is now being used. This stylesheet is now within a CSS folder, which folder is inside this HTML CSS integration root project. That is why we have created this root folder over here, inside of which we have placed everything that we will be using into this project. First of all, we are defining the folder name. It has to be something like this. So this is the syntax actually that should be declared over here. And here folder name means which folder name? The folder which is practically holding the required file of stylesheet.css, or any kind of file which is required to be declared over here to be connected to this page. So this stylesheet.css is inside this CSS folder. So that is what we will be providing here, CSS. And in the next case, we need to provide the file name, which is known as stylesheet. And what should be the extension name? CSS should be the extension name. Next, we are declaring the relevance of it, and it is, and the type of it is text by CSS. So this is the linkage of stylesheet.css along with this index.html. Now we need to check up whether this link is being established or not. So that is why we will be getting back to our project, reloading, and we can see that already this page is now connected. We have placed here this HTML element. We have provided this background color of this HTML page should be this one. This HTML page should be what? Dark colored. And that is exactly what we are observing, we are looking at right now. So we can safely conclude that this particular stylesheet.css is now linked to index.html.